Welcome back, Love Nation. This is Nina. Like, share, and subscribe. Thank you to everybody that has been coming to this channel. Like this video, share this video, and hit that notification bell. I have actually taken a break from making long videos. Thank you to everybody that has been subscribing to my food shorts. I am going to get straight into this alarming video in which four people went to Mexico for a medical tourism, and unfortunately it ended up very tragically for two people in this group. I definitely want to send prayers to their family, and I want their story to be a wake-up call. You definitely have to be out on the lookout when you're visiting different countries. You're not familiar with these specific areas and what is going on. Sometimes getting cheaper medical procedures done is not worth your life. I am going to get into this article, and I want you guys to tell me what you think in the comments below. So I'm going to read this article courtesy of CNN. You guys, we're just going to get straight into this article, and this is according to CNN. Two of the four Americans that were kidnapped in Mexico's border city of Matamoros on last Friday were found passed away, and two are still alive as of Tuesday, the U.S. and Mexican officials reported. Shaeed Woodard and Zendale Brown were found deceased. A U.S. official familiar with the ongoing investigation told CNN that their remains will be examined by Mexican authorities prior to the remains being turned over to the U.S. government, the official said. And just to update you guys on, again, what exactly happened in this case, Latavia Washington McGee, a mother of six, and Eric Williams were the sole survivors of the ordeal, according to the official. They were taken to a Texas hospital for treatment and observation. A Mexican government official said Washington McGee was found uninjured. Williams was pow-powed twice in one leg and once in the other, his wife Michelle Williams confirmed to CNN on Tuesday. And again, you guys, this is why you definitely have to be careful when you are attempting to go to these foreign countries to get various services. You never know what you are going to walk into. You do not know all of the cultural means of specific areas, or in some cases, a lot of people are not familiar with crime and whatever else is going on in the area. So even though it might be more cost effective to, you know, try to get these types of surgeries outside of the country, you also have to weigh your options on, are you actually going to be safe and should you actually do this? Now I'm going to go further into this article. One person has been detained in connection to the incident. Tamaulipas Governor Americo Valeril said, excuse me if I mispronounced that, but officials would not confirm whether the person is related to the actual crime organization. The victims were found in a wooden house in Matamoros and had been transferred to various places over the days in order to create confusion and avoid rescue efforts, Valerio said. Now, again, this goes back into this unfortunate case of this young lady visiting Mexico with her friends. They accompanied her in order to get a cheaper BBL surgery. The discovery of the Americans' whereabouts comes days after the four were abducted at, you know, Pow Pow Point in Matamoros in what is believed to be a case of mistaken identity. The tight-knit group of friends traveled from South Carolina to Mexico so Washington McGee could undergo a medical procedure across the border Friday, but they never made it to the appointment, two family members told CNN. The group crossed into Matamoros in the state of Tamaulipas at about 9:18 a.m. Friday, Villarreal said. but they got lost while trying to locate the medical clinic. According to Washington McGee's close friend, who did not want to be identified, they reached out to the doctor's office for directions on Friday, but were struggling to communicate with the office because they had a poor cell phone signal. After crossing the border, they were pow-powed upon by unidentified people, placed in a vehicle, and taken from the scene by armed men, according to the FBI. Investigators believe the Americans were targeted by a Mexican cartel that likely mistook them for Haitian smugglers, the U.S. official said. The U.S. citizens have no concerning criminal history that has been identified by investigators, the official said. An innocent Mexican bystander was also deleted in the encounter. The U.S. ambassador to Mexico, Ken Salazar, said the woman was pow-powed by a stray pow almost a block and a half from where the Americans were taken. Tamaulipas Governor Americo Villarreal said Tuesday. Their abduction highlights the ongoing issues that have plagued some Mexican cities during the long-running Mexican war, as well as the growing business of medical tourism. Matamoros has a population of more than 500,000 people and is located just across the Rio Grande from Brownsville, Texas. The U.S. Department has issued a level 4 do not travel advisory for U.S. citizens thinking of going to Tamaulipas, citing crime and kidnapping. Now, again, this is really, really why you definitely have to be extremely careful when you're visiting such places, be it that it is for medical tourism or even for vacation spots. You really, really do need to, you know, look into what you might be walking into, because you never know. And again, this comes actually on the heels of another incident with the Cabo 6, which is a whole different story, in which their investigation almost seems to be botched in comparison to this current incident. So, continuing this article, federal and local Mexican authorities were participating in the effort to locate the Americans and has set up a joint task force to communicate with U.S. officials. Tamaulipas Attorney General Irving Barrios Mexico said, U.S. enforcement was not involved on the ground in Mexico in the search for the missing Americans, Valerio said at the news conference on Tuesday. Mexican officials displayed a timeline of the search, including photos of the cars believed to be used by the kidnappers before they were found Tuesday morning. The Mexico Secretary of Security, Rosa Isilis Rodriguez, said that authorities in Mexico had been in constant communication with the U.S. ambassador and other U.S. officials since Sunday. State Department spokesman Ned Price thanked Mexican partners for facilitating the recovery of the Americans. Ultimately, we want to see accountability for what's been going on that has been inflicted on these Americans that tragically led to the deletion of two of them, he said. He also did not rule out designating drug cartels as a terrorist organization, something that some Republican lawmakers has called for, but said we are always going to look at every tool that is by law or any other authority available to us to attempt to work with our Mexican partners to crack down on what is a threat to Mexicans and to Americans alike. So I just wanted to read this article to you guys to give you guys some insight on what is going on. And again, only two of the four people have come back from Mexico alive. Prayers to this family. I would like to hear your comments concerning this story. Like, share, and subscribe, you guys. And until next time, enjoy your day and please be safe. Bye, guys.